Good morning, students. I hope you all understood the first lesson of geography. Dear students, before entering into the lesson, please note down all the points which is presented in this video. Then only you can revise and understand the continuity of the lesson. Okay, it starts our lesson. From this section, we are going to learn second lesson of geography, that is climate and natural vegetation of India. In this lesson, we are going to learn about the factors controlling the climate of India, the characteristics of different seasons in India. Next is about rainfall distribution in India, then the different types of natural vegetation and wildlife in India. Let's see the introduction. The weather condition will be vary between North and South India. First, we will see what is weather and what is climate. Weather is short-term condition and climate is average daily weather for an extended period of time at a certain location. Let's see in detail about weather and climate. Weather refers to the state of atmosphere over an area at any point of time. The elements of both weather and climate are same. It is the combination of temperature, humidity, precipitation, wind, cloudiness and other atmospheric conditions at a specific time. Next is about climate. Climate is the characteristic condition of the atmosphere near the Earth's surface at a certain place on Earth. It refers to the sum total of weather conditions and variation over a large area for a long period of time. It is the long-term weather of that area which remains at least 30 years. See this picture for better understanding. Weather will change within few minutes or hours, but climate will take long time to change. Next, we are going to see what are the factors affecting the climate. So the factors are latitude, altitude, distance from the sea, monsoon wind, relief, and jet streams. Let's see one by one. First, latitude. In Earth, the equator region receives direct sunlight, so it has very hot temperature. This is called torrid zone. Then the Tropic of Cancer receives little slanting sun rays than equator. This is called temperate zone, which is also called tropical region. Due to the curvature of the Earth, the amount of solar energy received varies according to the latitude. Latitudinally, India lies between 8 degree 4 minutes north and 37 degree 6 minutes north latitude. Already we learnt in last lesson that Tropic of Cancer will divide our country into two halves. So based on this Tropic of Cancer, our country is divided into subtropical region in north and tropical region in south. See this picture. So based on the Tropic of Cancer, our country is divided into two parts. The northern part is called subtropical region and the southern part is called tropical region. This subtropical region is away from the equator. Therefore, it experiences extreme climate with a high daily and annual range of temperature. Next, in southern part, the tropical region is closer to equator, thus experiences high temperature throughout the year with small daily and annual range. Next factor is altitude. Altitude means height. When the height increases, the temperature decreases. Temperature decreases at the rate of 6.5 degrees Celsius for every 1000 meter of descent. It is called normal lapse rate. students, it is your important 2 mark. Please note it down. Temperature decreases at the rate of 6.5 degrees Celsius for every 1000 meter of descent. It is called normal lapse rate. Hence, places in the mountains are cooler than the places on the plains. See this picture. As one goes from the surface of the earth to higher altitude, the atmosphere becomes less dense and temperature decreases. The next factor is distance from the sea. It does not cause only temperature and pressure variations, but also affects the amount of rainfall. Air near the coast has more moisture and greater potential to produce precipitation. Due to this fact, the coastal area receives high rainfall. For example, Kolkata region receives high rainfall. Before explains this factor, see this example. If you heat an empty vessel, it heats up quickly and then cools down quickly. If you heat a vessel with water, it heats up slowly and cools down slowly. Like that example, due to the heat produced by the solar energy, sea heats up slowly and cools down slowly like a vessel with water. The land heats up quickly and cools down quickly like an empty vessel. Because of this factor, in summer, cold sea keeps coastal area cooler. In winter, heat is released by the sea, keeping coastal areas warmer than inland. So, the places that are influenced by sea temperature have a maritime climate, that is, wet climate with a small temperature range. Places inland that are not influenced by sea temperatures have a continental climate, that is, dry climate with a large temperature range. Next factor is about monsoon wind. That is the most dominant factor which affects the climate of India. These are seasonal reversal winds, and India remains in the influence of these winds for a considerable part of a year. See this picture. Monsoon means season. So seasonal winds that blow from a particular area towards a particular region in a particular direction. So this monsoon winds is classified into 2 types, that is southwest monsoon and northeast monsoon. This southwest monsoon blows from sea to land area and northeast monsoon it's blow from land to sea area. Always this monsoon winds blow from high pressure area to low pressure area. During winter monsoon, it is blow from land part to sea part. During summer monsoon, it is move from sea part to land part, that is high pressure area to low pressure area. So see this picture. The sun rays are vertical over the central part of India during the mid-June. The summer season ends in India by the end of May. It is because one set of southwest monsoon brings down the temperature of the entire India and causes moderate to heavy rainfall in many parts of the country. So this southwest monsoon only brings rainfall to our country. See the picture. The northeast monsoon blows in the month of October to March, and southwest monsoon blows in the month of April to September. The next factor is relief. Relief means landforms. Relief of India has a great bearing on major elements of climate such as temperature, atmospheric pressure, direction of wind, and the amount of rainfall. For example, Himalayas. For example, Himalayas act as a barrier to the freezing cold wind blows from Central Asia and keep the Indian subcontinent warm. As such, the North India experiences drop climate even during winter. The next factor is jet streams. Jet stream is nothing but fast moving wind in a narrow zone in the upper atmosphere. In this video, we can understand the westerly jet stream and easterly jet stream. Jet stream is a fast moving wind between stratosphere and troposphere layer, which is located closely to tropopause. Its speed varies from 110 km per hour in summer and 184 km per hour in winter. In terms of latitude, this jet stream is located approximately over 27 degree to 30 degree north latitude. So it is called subtropical westerly jet stream because they are very close to the tropical areas. This jet stream moves in a zigzag manner. It starts, stops, and can split into two or more parts and combine into one stream or flow into various directions, including the opposite direction. Over India, this jet stream flows south of the Himalayas all through the year except in summer. In summer, the subtropical westerly jet stream moves north of the Himalayas because of the movement of the sun. Here, the Tibetan Plateau is heated up and develops low pressure area. It pulls the jet stream towards north. This low pressure area attracts the adjacent wind. This wind not only comes closer, it also bends. In northern hemisphere, it bends towards right because of Coriolis effect. We can call this as cyclone. In this region, the wind moves in anti-clockwise direction. The warm air in this region is rising up and reaches tropopause. Here, the temperature becomes low and the pressure is high. Now, if the pressure is high, the wind present in this region, it's move away from the region. As the wind move towards northern hemisphere, it bends to right. It is not only bend, also rotates in clockwise direction, which is called anticyclone. The cyclone move in an anti-clock direction and anticyclone moves clockwise direction. This anticyclone in the upper troposphere weakened the western subtropical jet stream. It also produces the tropical easterly jet stream on the south side of the anticyclone. Now, this western subtropical jet stream divided into two, one moves in the northern part of the Tibetan Plateau and other moves in southern part. Finally, in the northeastern part of India, it develops into easterly jet stream on the southern side of the anticyclone. The high temperature over the Tibetan Plateau and Central Asia during the summer leads to the formation of easterly jet stream over India. It moves towards west side of India and Africa. So, westerly jet stream helps in arrival of monsoon and easterly jet stream helps in sudden outbreak of monsoon. Here I gave some reference link which is related to this topic. Please go through it for better understanding. Then I gave evaluation questions. Try to answer this question. What is mean by normal lapse rate? What are jet streams? Differentiate weather and climate. Define monsoon. Thank you, students.